If we look at the history of materials innovation and materials development, it is characterized by what has been available at large commodity scale. But it's been a function of what's been available and not thinking about product design and product development through the lens of how can we make a better material? How can we make a better thing that improves the performance of that product, that makes a better experience for the consumer?
Our algal oils are one of the key components of this polymer. And so there's a whole world of formulation that we can do. We can take these polyols and use those in a variety of different formulations to make something like this, which is a high density foam, something you might find in our ski product, for example.
Biology unlocks this potential to enable a more intentional design of materials. And the ABPDU is instrumental in our being able to show at a larger scale that we can do this in pilot scale fermentation capacity.
The equipment you see here in the lab costs millions of dollars. We need the utilities, the expertise to use that. If you're scaling something up and you don't know it's going to work, it's a huge risk to invest in that equipment. So the nice thing that we can do at ABPDU is we can get people in here, they can de-risk their technology, then they can either directly commercialize that, or they can go back in and purchase the equipment themselves, get it right after they've de-risked it, after they've gotten that next round of funding, and then they can scale with confidence.
Most consumers associate petroleum, whether that is things like polyester or nylon, as being high performance products. But if we can get to those materials, or if we can get to totally new classes of materials based on things that come from biology, where we don't have to extract crude oil, or where the agricultural practices are much better, if we can do that in a more thoughtful and responsible way, that's better for people and it's better for the planet, that's a great thing.